Yeah, of course.
You have pushed that button, eh?
I have pushed the button on the screen.
At this point, you have finally realized, eh?
What I have done on the runway, yes.
So this is it. Friends, salute and welcome to the British Brothers RC Aviation channel. The channel where we will try to test as many different planes as possible while we still have time. The channel where we don't edit nothing. And of course, the channel where you can all feel at home, and the channel where we will try to.
Where you can all feel hope?
We can all feel hope here.
Yes.
And you can all feel at home on this channel. Because we're all brothers and sisters, RC brothers and sisters, we just have different mothers, eh?
Yes. Did you see that? Sexy?
Yeah, of course, eh?
I'll have to disassemble this engine.
Yeah, but that will not go on this planet.
No, that is for Stuka. For a friend, yes.
I was trying to say something, eh?
You're talking about something about the Fokkers.
I didn't start to talk about the Fokker planes. Of course, the famous question, what do we have today? Now, I think that for me, I've waited to unbox this plane the most, eh? Of course, Captain Blush, you were waiting to unbox your plane, that beautiful, sexy tiger moth in the back that you're assembling right now. Don't go too close because we're filming the video.
Look at the tools.
Turn back to me. Turn back to me. But what are you filming, Captain Blush? I didn't say a long time filming, Captain Blush. Eh?
Uh-huh.
I think that I was really waiting for this one because why I will tell you this now. First, the famous question on this channel, what do we have today? This is the, what? Yeah, of course, two boxes there. This is the third plane from that beautiful five planes unboxing that I have clicked on the Hobby King. And today we have the beautiful and sexy, as you can see here, Fokker D7. Now, sometimes I see this, it's written DR7. I don't know what that means, but we will go with this, Fokker D7. Now this, in fact, is the Warbird. Most of the planes on our channel, you will see the Warbirds from the Second World War.
Hey, but Tiger Moth is actually, isn't Tiger Moth also from World War?
I will tell you now the secret, because you were listening when we were filming. What is Tiger Moth? That is not from World War I.
What?
The Tiger Moth is from the World War II, because in fact the pilots who were later flying Spitfires were training first on the Tiger Moth.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Now you know the truth, Captain Blush. But this Fokker DR7.
So Tiger Moth is English?
Yeah, of course it is. And that was a trainer plane for the Spitfire pilots. But this one, in fact, this is a Warbird from the World War I, the German fighter. I mean, they were simple back then, eh? But they were still deadly, eh? And what's the point of this? Now, this one, for once, I can also recommend to all foam lovers, because if you are a foam lover, that means that usually you have the electro plane. You don't like to mess with glow and gas like Captain Blush, but I will salute Captain Blush for that. Because even I just love the foam plane so much in electro, I will admit that a good Bulsa plane with the glow engine on or gas, that is the peak of pilot's life.
Yes.
But the foams are fast, the foams are cheaper, they are cleaner. But today I have something even for the foam lovers. What?
There is a knife on the table.
Hey, you hanky panky man. Of course I can cut one talking. Hey, look at Captain Blush. Of course, I know that you're all anxious to assemble your Tiger Moth, so I can.
Yeah, because the eraser, the days for this year are running out, eh?
Yeah, this is the last unboxing of this year. I mean, but you know what's the point?
I will not even assemble it.
You still
it.
Have what?
I will not show it because the
camera. 7 hours left of this year. 7 hours, I mean, Captain Blush, I think that...
Watch this. Tuesday, 4 o'clock, 4 p.m.
And for the last few days, we were so productive with these videos that this is CK.
Yes.
Now, and this kind of filming, K, that would be our dream, eh? that every day we can be around the planes and film them. And of course we can't. We don't film this for money, so
give it
must
also
work. But no, wait, I was trying to say something. I was trying to persuade the viewers who love electro planes and who love foam planes that for once, this is an option for you. It's still electro, don't worry. It runs on simple 2200
3 cell
battery, but it is balsa plane covered with foil.
Oh, just like Piet and Paul.
Yeah.
Hey, maybe this
because
will be...
the truth, eh?
Hey.
Maybe it's the same size as Piet and Paul.
Yeah, maybe we can convert this to glow.
Yeah, we were talking about that, but wait.
Because Piet and Paul was actually only electric version.
Of course it was. Yeah, we were talking that maybe later.
And we have two of them.
You will convert this to... But wait, did we see the plane? I was just trying to persuade the viewers that for once maybe the foam lovers have a chance to have beautiful Warbird from World War I in the balsa version, eh? And believe me that you will love it, believe me. To fly with this, eh, in the air, it looks much sexier. And
no, just start to open.
I can't imagine... Yeah, I will open. I can't...
Yo.
I can't just imagine this bird... The Fokker 7 to be in the foam version. It can't be more beautiful than the balsa one. But the point is that this is the first time in my life that I have seen the balsa plane in plug and fly version. Now, I didn't see that before. Usually you get the kit or the ARF version, but not the plug and fly.
I will die
this
here.
This is finally coming off. Look, this will be...
Just open it before midnight.
No, tako, like this, eh?
Yeah, tako, yeah.
Come here.
Why?
Because this will be the first time that we will see the balsa plane in plug and fly version be revealed on this channel. I'm ready to see something. Look at this, eh? Look at this,
hey,
my friends.
There is nothing to do, almost. Look at this.
Yeah, of course it's not, and that is why we are showing you this, eh?
Just some glue and that's it. For the tail, rudder and horizontal and vertical stabilizer,
I mean,
and that's it.
You will have a little feeling how it is to assemble the balsa plane, because the main part always on the balsa plane is to glue together the tail of the plane. That is the most interesting one. But
no,
this time
start
I think,
here, start here.
No, I will start.
No, you
where?
Will start here.
I will start with this.
Yes.
No,
this time,
this time it will be different, eh? Because I'm not used to open the electro plug and fly plane, say. I will put it like this.
Good. Don't cut off your finger again, yeah.
No, of course not, eh? Yeah, but it's really good tech, look at this, eh? And now look at this balsa. For once, Pilot Robert is not taking
off. Oh, this will not be, this will not be for glow, eh?
He's not taking out the foam planes. Now look at this sexiness. Show this to the viewers, eh?
Look how tiny this is.
The control horn.
Ooh, carbon.
Already installed, eh? Huh? Mm-hmm. I will open this. Yes. This is something. You believe me, if you didn't have the balsa plane before in your life, you will be pretty surprised when you will hold the pieces like this in your hand, eh? But hey, look how good quality this is covered. Look at this.
Laser cut?
I just wondered, you know what?
What?
Look.
What?
Like on big birds, this one has to be glued, the hinge. Show me this one.
This also? No.
This is. There must be some reason that one is still not glued. Look at this. But it's so light, eh? The balsa wood is so light, eh?
Oh, look at the prop, eh?
I will go here. Look at this, some middle section. Now, good thing, Captain Blush, now why am I unboxing this and why did I bought this? Because I knew that Captain Blush will be here in the workshop assembling his Tiger Moth and, of course, you will help me a little to glue this one, eh? Because I'm not used to glue the balsa plane. I didn't glue a single balsa in my life, eh? Over foam, but look at this, eh? Look at this small middle section, how beautiful and sexy it is done. Tell me that you're not impressed by the quality.
Yes, it's very nice.
And now let's get here.
The wooden
this will be something to be scale as hell. You get, look at this, a beautiful and sexy look. How beautiful this looks,
Oh, vintage, wooden, vintage look.
Vintage prop, And with the double size of the wings, I know right now that this will fly good, even though it is 1 meter wingspan,
Yes. What's this?
I will put it out on the
spinner.
I can leave it in, The
prop adapter.
The prop adapter. Now we come here, look at this.
Undercarriage. Oh, wing support.
Look at this. All the wing supports, look. Oh.
Metal.
Steel. And of course inside are the
aluminum.
The screws. But the best part of this is that this plane is so small and still it has the scale wheels,
Wheels?
Look at this sexy wheels, And not so small,
No.
Now this will take off from our carpet, Look at this sexy size, What are you looking? What?
Uh-huh, yeah, okay, now I understand.
I understand what you're thinking, the tail wheel?
No.
This one didn't have the tail
wheel. No, I'm looking at this.
What?
At the undercarriage, how it's made.
Ah, look at this sexiness, Two wheels, of course, the sexy undercarriage, Some nuts, and this is the axle.
Axle, yes. Axle rose, yes.
I will put it here. And now let's go to the sexy, beautiful
wings.
Wings. Oh.
Already.
look at this, Small little devil, But it looks so sexy already, Captain Blush?
Yes.
You must see. Now this is the bottom wing. I think so, It is. Couldn't be.
Yeah, of course it is.
The upper one, because the bottom is a little
smaller.
Smaller, Now this you must handle with a little more care. Because to put the finger through this, you will have the hole, And look at this piece of art, Look. Look how shiny it is. Show this to the viewers, the series,
Yeah.
And look how good it is covered,
Very good.
For such a small bird.
No wrinkles.
No wrinkles, no nothing, Now this can be your hanger king, or queen or something. If you're the foam lover and to have this baby also in the hanger, I think that you will hang this in the place that everybody will see when they will visit you, Now, of course, the upper wing. This will be some maiden flight, Look at this, But right now, Captain Blush, at this moment, I don't think so that it will happen, but can you imagine this baby with some small 4 cc engine?
I don't know, because...
Servos already pre-installed for you, look at this, The cables and that's it, The wings are covered.
Yes.
Extensions. This looks so good,
Oh, did you hear that?
Yeah.
A bomb exploded.
New year is coming, viewers. Look at this. Now they have put it a little wire here to hold the plane in place. And that's it, That is all that you have in this box of this beautiful and sexy Fokker from Amade.
Yes. Where were this made? In Germany,
Yeah, this plane exactly, I don't think so. But originally this is the German fighter.
Yes.
Look at this, Look at this sexiness, and be impressed, Small but so good looking. Look.
Show me the cowling,
Look at this, The cowling, look at this scale cowling. And motor already pre-installed.
Wait.
The brushless, look at this,
Cooling.
I just wonder now.
What?
Oh, look at this. Look, servos already pre-installed.
Show me.
Show this. I mean, this, hey. I just wonder if I will even fly this plane. I will just hang this in my hangar because, hey, I can hang this directly.
Where do you open this?
Above my desk in the office because this looks so sexy and scary.
Yeah, where do you open this?
I think that it must be here somewhere on
the
floor.
No, no, no. Oh, I can see 60.
Oh, look at this.
Imagine.
Of course, I will put here a little tape, but look at this, hey.
And I can already see 60.
Oh, please visit. Oh, look at this little commercial, eh? Uh-huh. Do you see this, eh? Please visit www.hobbyking.com product page under the files, tab for assembly instructions. Yeah, of course, like always, I mean, they do try to save the forest, so you have the instruction manuals in the files beneath this. Of course, I will put the link of this plane under the video in the description. And all that you need to know, you can download there. But look at this, eh?
Pull out XT60.
Aha!
What?
Yeah, this is the place for the battery, eh?
Yes.
Hey, oh, I just love this, because you don't have to screw a lot.
But wait, give me this.
No, 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 it won't go here. The receiver, maybe, I will put it here.
XT60 is inside.
Is it?
Yes.
I must check quick.
No, from the top. From the cockpit side. Oi, cockpit side.
Oh, of course, eh? I can see it here, eh?
You have to pull it towards the front.
I will pull it here. I will just put that.
But that will be for later.
Not now. Yeah, but maybe. Is it? If you put this on, how come that it is here in the back? But this is the place for the battery, huh? I don't think you, here it will be the wing, here it will be the wing, but this part is outside.
This
is the place for the battery, of course it is, because look at this, this is big enough, eh? But of course for this time, where is it? Aha, one magnet, two magnets, you have one magnet even in the front, even though it is under the coverage, look at this, eh? And for this XT60, hey. I must salute Hobby King because we just lost XT60. So this is it, Captain Blush.
Yes.
Hey, but this is something great. Look at this sexiness, Dave. Hey, I think that every pilot would love to have this one, eh? And I can really recommend it at this moment, eh? Because I know that it will fly good, eh?
Of course.
Oh, look at this, eh?
Uh-huh.
Look.
No, hey, but the propeller is really sexy.
It will like it will be, eh? Good enough. Look at this. Look at this and be impressed, eh?
It's enough.
But what's this?
This is for undercarriage, huh? Do you remember?
Oh, of course, eh? I was thinking what this is again. Yeah, of course, this goes between the undercarriage, and I think that this is pretty crucial for this plane. This is not just some phony baloney stuff that looks good on
It looks like a wing.
Yeah, it works like a wing for the extra stabilization of the plane. Of course, this will go here. The axle go through this, and this will go between the wheels, eh? Hey, this is pretty sexy, huh, Captain Blush, eh?
Yeah.
Such a small... This is like a...
It will fall out, don't put it on.
This is like a small, precious plane in your hand, eh? Look at this, eh? And it will fly good because it has double the surface of the wings, eh? Because of that, I know it is almost like this is 1.3 meter wingspan, and this is so light, eh? And so sexy, and this will be something. Eh? So this is it, Captain Blush.
Yes.
I can't wait to start to assemble this, eh?
Will you start now?
Of course. Huh?
Will you assemble it now?
Well, hey, if you will help me with the tail of the wheel, eh? Because at the end, you glue this, and then all the rest, it is just...
Screwing.
...put together construction, and that's it, eh?
You will just screw here, and that's it.
A beautiful and sexy little project, I will call this, eh? And if this will be successful, maybe flight, hey, this will be the World War all over again, eh? On our runway. So this is it.
Yes.
What to tell at the end, a few words. By now, I can really see that this is really, really beautifully done. Beautiful warbird from the World War I, And this is the first time, like I have said, that I have seen the Bulls are playing covered with foil that it is in the plug and fly version. All servers already pre-installed for you, the motor in, and that's it. And it will run on that simple free S 2200 that I think that everybody has at home. And with this, if you have a good runway or a carpet, or even with this, we'll say a super trimmed grass, I think that everybody will check this bird out when you will go on the runway. So this is it.
Yes.
I can really recommend it at this time, but maiden flight will be next day. So this is it. Pilot Robert and Captain Lars signing off from Slovenia with the beautiful, sexy Fokker D7, the iconic Warbird fighter, German fighter from the World War I that can make your collection of planes even more beautiful. So this is it. No, Captain Lars, beep! Because we don't have much time left,
Yes.
But viewers, who cares, because tomorrow is another day and we will start the new year all over again, and then the madness will start all over again for the next 365 days. Thanks for your support, for visiting our channel, for all your comments, for your subscriptions. We love you, every single one of you. If you ever come to Slovenia, you're welcome to visit us. Slovenia is small, but we have it all. Beautiful little country with great people, and that's it. And we're just our simple brothers here, having fun and living our dreams in this RC world. No, Captain Blush, enough. Right now, at this point.